We are not going to have a problem at all. When Joe says that I said, Anthony Fauci said, and others, and many others, and I'm not knocking him a lot. Nobody knew. Look, nobody knew what this thing was. Nobody knew where it was coming from, what it was. We've learned a lot. But Anthony said, don't wear masks. Now he wants to wear masks. Anthony also said, if you look back, exact words, here's his exact words. This is no problem. This is going to go away soon. So he's allowed to make mistakes. He happens to be a good person.
Vice President Biden, your response quickly, and then we're going to move on to the next section.
My response is that think about what the president knew in January and didn't tell the American people. He was told this was a serious virus that spread in the air, and it was much worse than the flu. He went on record and said to one of your colleagues, recorded, that in fact he knew how dangerous it was, but he didn't want to tell us. He didn't want to tell us because he didn't want us to panic. He didn't want us, Americans don't panic. He panicked. But guess what? In the meantime, we find out in the New York Times the other day that, in fact, his folks went to Wall Street and said this is a really dangerous thing. And a memo out of that meeting, not from his administration, but from some of the brokers, said sell short because we got to get moving. It's a dangerous problem.
Well, this is
I'm
going
to give you 30 seconds to respond, and then we're
the
going to move
one,
on.
I don't know. Somebody went to Wall Street. You're the one that takes all the money from Wall Street. I don't take it.
I have.
You have raised a lot of money. Tremendous amounts of money. And every time you raise money, deals are made, you know. I could raise so much more money as president and as somebody that knows most of those people. I could call the heads of Wall Street, the heads of every company in America. I would blow away every record, but I don't want to do that because it puts me in a bad position. And then you bring up Wall Street. You shouldn't be bringing up Wall Street because you're the one that takes the money from Wall Street, not me. I could blow away your records. That, like you wouldn't believe, we don't need money. We have plenty of money. In fact, we beat Hillary Clinton with a tiny fraction of the money that she was able to.
All right, gentlemen, we're going to move on.
Don't tell me about Wall Street.
Average contribution, $43.
All right, we're going to move on to our next section, which is national security. And I do want to start with the security of our elections and some breaking news from overnight. Just last night, top intelligence officials confirmed again that both Russia and Iran are working to influence this election. Both countries have obtained U.S. voter registration information, these officials say, and Iran sent intimidating messages to Florida voters. This question goes to you, Mr. Vice President. What would you do to put an end to this threat? You have 2 minutes uninterrupted.
I made it clear, and I ask everyone else to take the pledge. I made it clear that any country, no matter who it is, that interferes in American elections will pay a price. They will pay a price. It's been overwhelmingly clear this election, I won't even get into the last one, this election, that Russia has been involved, China has been involved to some degree, and now we learn that Iran is involved. They will pay a price if I'm elected. They're interfering with American sovereignty. That's what's going on right now. They're interfering with American sovereignty. And to the best of my knowledge, I don't think the president said anything to Putin about it. I don't think he's stalking them a lot. I don't think he said a word. I don't know why he hadn't said a word to Putin about it. And I don't know what he has recently said, if anything, to the Iranians. My guess is he'd probably be more outspoken with regard to the Iranians. But the point is this, folks. We are in a situation where we have foreign countries trying to interfere in the outcome of our election. His own national security advisor told him that what is happening with his buddy, his buddy, Rudy Giuliani, he's being used as a Russian pawn. He's being fed information that is Russian, that is not true. And then what happens? Nothing happens. And then you find out that everything that's going on here about Russia is wanting to make sure that I do not get elected the next president of the United States because they know I know them and they know me. I don't understand why this president is unwilling to take on Putin when he's actually paying bounties to kill American soldiers in Afghanistan, when he's engaged in activities that are trying to destabilize all of NATO. I don't know why he doesn't do it, but it's worth asking the question, why isn't that being done? Any country that interferes with us will, in fact, pay a price because they're affecting our sovereignty.
President Trump. Same question to you. Let me ask the question. You're going to have 2 minutes to respond. For two elections in a row now, there has been substantial interference from foreign adversaries. What would you do in your next term to put an end to this? 2 minutes uninterrupted.
Well, let me respond to the first part, as Joe answered. Joe got $3.5 million from Russia, and it came through Putin because he was very friendly with the former mayor of Moscow, and it was the mayor of Moscow's wife, and you got $3.5 million. Your family got $3.5 million, and you know, someday you're gonna have to explain why did you get $3.5 million. I never got any money from Russia. I don't get money from Russia. Now, about your thing last night, I knew all about that. And through John Ratcliffe, who is fantastic, Dee and I, he said, the one thing that's common to both of them, they both want you to lose, because there has been nobody tougher to Russia with between the sanctions, nobody tougher than me on Russia. Between the sanctions, between all of what I've done with NATO, you know, I've got the NATO countries to put up an extra $130 billion going to $420 billion a year. That's to guard against Russia. I sold, while he was selling pillows and sheets, I sold tank busters to Ukraine. There has been nobody tougher on Russia than Donald Trump. And I'll tell you, they were so bad. They took over the submarine port. You remember that very well. During your term, during you and Barack Obama, they took over a big part of what should have been Ukraine. You handed it to them. But you were getting a lot of money from Russia. They were paying you a lot of money, and they probably still are. But now, with what came out today, it's even worse. All of the emails, the horrible emails of the kind of money that you were raking in, you and your family. And Joe, you were vice president when some of this was happening, and it should have never happened. And I think you owe an explanation to the American people. Why is it? Somebody just had a news conference a little while ago who was essentially supposed to work with you and your family, but what he said was damning. And regardless of me, I think you have to clean it up and talk to the American people. Maybe you can do it right now.
Vice President Biden, you may respond. And then I want to follow up on the election security.
I have not taken a penny from any foreign source ever in my life. We learned that this president paid 50 times the tax in China, has a secret bank account with China, does business in China, and in fact is talking about me taking money. I have not taken a single penny from any country whatsoever, ever. Number one. Number two, this is a president, I have released all of my tax returns, 22 years, go look at them, 22 years of my tax return. You have not released a single solitary year of your tax return. What are you hiding? Why are you unwilling? The foreign countries are paying you a lot. Russia's paying you a lot. China's paying you a lot. And your hotels and all your businesses all around the country, all around the world. And China's building a new road to a new golf course you have overseas. So what's going on here? Why don't release your tax return or stop talking about corruption?
President Trump, your response.
First of all, I called my accountants, underwrote it. I'm going to release them as soon as we can. I want to do it. And it'll show how successful, how great this company is. But much more importantly than that, people were saying $750. I asked them a week ago, I said, what did I pay? They said, sir, you prepaid tens of millions of dollars. I prepaid my tax. Tens over the last number of years, tens of millions of dollars I prepaid, because at some point they think it's an estimate. They think I may have to pay tax. So I already prepaid it. Nobody told me that.
Did your accountant
Nobody
tell
you,
you
that? Excuse
them?
Me. And it wasn't written. Whenever they write this, they keep talking about $750, which I think is a filing fee. But let me just tell you, I prepaid millions and millions of dollars in taxes. Number one. Number two, I don't make money from China. You do. I don't make money from Ukraine. You do. I don't make money from Russia. You made $3.5 million, Joe. And your son gave you. They even have a statement that we have to give 10% to the big man. You're the big man, I think. I don't know, maybe you're not, but you're the big man, I think. Your son said we have to give 10% to the big man. Joe, what's that all about? It's terrible.
All right, gentlemen, I want to ask you both some questions about all of this. I'm going
to
let you both respond very quickly. You just said you spoke to your accountant about potentially releasing your taxes. Did he tell you when you can release them? Do you have a deadline for when you're going to release them?
I get treated worse than the Tea Party got treated. Because I have a lot of people in there, deep down in the IRS, they treat me horribly. We made a deal, it was all settled until I decide to run for president. I get treated very badly by the IRS, very unfairly. But we had a deal all done. As soon as we're completed with the deal, I want to release it. But I have paid millions and millions of dollars, and it's worse than paying. I paid in advance. It's called prepaying your taxes. Okay. I paid in advance.
I want to ask you both about questions regarding your potential foreign entanglements and questions that have been raised to give you both a chance to talk about this more broadly. Respond very quickly, and then I'll get to my question.
Why did he's been saying this for 4 years? Show us. Just show us. Stop playing around. You've been saying for 4 years you're going to reduce your taxes. Nobody knows, Mr. President. What they do know is you're not paying your taxes, or you're paying taxes that are so low. When last time he said what he paid, he said, I only pay that little because I'm smart. I know how to game the system. Come on. Come on, folks.
So, President Trump, and then I want to get to two questions to both of you.
Sure.
I was put through a phony witch hunt for 3 years. It started before I even got elected. They spied on my campaign. No president should ever have to go through what I went through. Let me just say this. Mueller and 18 angry Democrats and FBI agents all over the place spent $48 million. They went through everything I had, including my tax returns, and they found absolutely no collusion and nothing wrong. $48 million. I guarantee you, if I spent $1 million on you, Joe, I could find plenty wrong. Because
All right.
the kind of things that you've done and the kind of monies that your family has taken, I mean, your brother made money in Iraq, millions of dollars. Your other brother made a fortune. And it's all through you, Joe. And they say you get some of it. And you do live very well. You have houses all over the place. You live very well.
All right, gentlemen, let me just ask questions about all of this broadly. Vice President Biden, there have been questions about the work your son has done in China and for a Ukrainian energy company when you were vice president. In retrospect, was anything about those relationships inappropriate or unethical?
Nothing was unethical. Here's what the deal. With regard to Ukraine, we had this whole question about whether or not, because he was on the board, I later learned, of a Burisma, a company, that somehow I had done something wrong. Yet every single solitary person, when he was going through his impeachment, testifying under oath who worked for him, said, I did my job impeccably. I carried out U.S. policy. Not one single solitary thing was out of line. Not a single thing, number one. Number two, the guy who got in trouble in Ukraine was this guy trying to bribe the Ukrainian government to say something negative about me, which they would not do and did not do because it never, ever, ever happened. My son has not made money in terms of this thing about, what are you talking about, China. I have not had, the only guy made money from China is this guy. He's the only one. Nobody else has made money from China.
President Trump, let me ask my question to you.
But could I just one thing?
Very quickly.
His son didn't have a job for a long time, was sadly no longer in the military service. I won't get into that. And he didn't have a job. As soon as he became vice president, Burisma, not the best reputation in the world, I hear they paid him $183,000 a month. Listen to this. $183,000, and they gave him a $3 million upfront payment.
All right.
And he had no energy.
I'm going to let the vice president respond to that quickly, and then
dishonest.
I need to get to a question to you. Very
no
quickly,
basis for that. Everybody investigated that. No one said anything he did was wrong in Ukraine.
Okay, President Trump, this is for you. Since you took office, you've never divested from your business. You've personally promoted your properties abroad. A report this week, which was referenced, does indicate that your company has a bank account in China. So how can voters know that you don't have any foreign conflicts of interest?
I have many bank accounts, and they're all listed, and they're all over the place. I mean, I was a businessman doing business. The bank account you're referring to, which is everybody knows about it, it's listed. The bank account was in 2013. That's what it was. It was opened in it was closed in 2015, I believe. And then I decided, because I was thinking about doing a deal in China like millions of other people. I was thinking about it, and I decided I'm not going to do it. Didn't like it. I decided not to do it. Had an account open, and I closed it.
Okay.
Excuse me. And then, unlike him, where he's vice president and he does business, I then decided to run for president after that. That was before. So I closed it before I even ran for president, let alone became president. Big difference. He is the vice president of the United States, and his son, his brother, and his other brother are getting rich. They're like a vacuum cleaner. They're sucking up money.
Okay, President Trump, thank you. We do need to move on. I do want to ask you, Vice President Biden, about China. Let's talk about China more broadly. There have, of course, President Trump has said that they should pay for not being fully transparent in regards to the coronavirus. If you were president, would you make China pay? And please be specific, what would that look like?
What I'd make China do is play by the international rules, not like he has done. He has caused the deficit of China to go up, not down, with China, up, not down. We are making sure that in order to do business in China, you have to give all your intellectual property. You have to have a partner in China. It's 51%. We would not do that at all, number one. Number two, we're in a situation where China would have to play by the rules internationally as well. When I met with Xi, when I was still vice president, he said, we're setting up air identification zones in the South China Sea. You can't fly through them. I said, we're going to fly through them. We just flew B-52, B-1 bombers through it. We're not going to pay attention. They have to play by the rules. And what's he do? He embraces guys like the thugs like in North Korea and the Chinese president and Putin and others. And he pokes his finger in the eye of all of our friends, all of our allies. We make up only, we're 25% of the world's economy. We need to be having the rest of our friends with us saying to China, these are the rules. You play by them or you're going to pay the price for not paying by them economically. That's the way I will run it. And that's what we did in upholding steel tariffs and a range of other things when we were president and vice president.
All right. Let's talk about North Korea.
Excuse me. No, I have to respond to that.
Okay. Very quickly, and then we're going to move on to North Korea.
With $1.5 billion from China to manage after spending 10 minutes in office and being in Air Force Two, number one. Number two, there's a very strong email talking about your family wanting to make $10 million a year for introductions.
President Trump, on China policy, though, what specifically are you going to do to make China pay? You've said you're going
First
to make
all,
them pay.
China is paying. They're paying billions and billions of dollars. I just gave $28 billion.
New sanctions?
Listen, I just gave $28 billion to our farmers.
Taxpayers' money.
Didn't come from China. You know who the taxpayer is? It's called China. China paid $28 billion, and you know what they did to pay it, Joe? They devalued their currency, and they also paid up. And you know who got the money? Our farmers, our great farmers, because they were targeted. You never charged them anything. Also, I charged them 25% on dumped steel because they were killing our steel industry. We were not going to have a steel industry.
Okay.
And now we have a steel industry.
Okay, Vice President Biden, your response, please.
My response is, look, this isn't about – there's a reason why he's bringing up all this malarkey. There's a reason for it. He doesn't want to talk about the substantive issues. It's not about his family and my family. It's about your family. And your family's hurting badly. If you're making less than, if you're a middle-class family, you're getting hurt badly right now. You're sitting at the kitchen table this morning deciding, well, we can't get new tires, they're bald because we have to wait another month or so. Or are we going to be able to pay the mortgage? Or who's going to tell her she can't go back to community college? They're the decisions you're making in the middle-class families like I grew up in Scranton and Claymont. They're in trouble. We should be talking about your families, but that's the last thing he wants to talk about.
I want to talk about North Korea. 10 seconds, Mr. President.
That's a typical political statement. Let's get off this China thing, and then he looks. The family, around the table, everything. A typical politician when I see that.
I'm not a typical politician. Okay,
that's why I got elected. Let's get off the subject of China. Let's talk around sitting around the table.
All right.
Come on, Joe, you can do better.
We're going to talk about North Korea now. President Trump, you've met with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un three times. You've talked about your beautiful letters with him. You've touted the fact that there hasn't been a war or a long-range missile test. And yet North Korea recently rolled out its biggest ever intercontinental ballistic missile and continues to develop its nuclear arsenal. Do you see that as a betrayal of the relationship you forged? Just 30 seconds here because we need to get on to the next
one. So when I met with Barack Obama, we sat in the White House. Right at the beginning, had a great conversation. It was supposed to be 15 minutes, and it was well over an hour. He said, the biggest problem we have with North Korea. He indicated we will be in a war with North Korea. Guess what? It would be a nuclear war. And he does have plenty of nuclear capability. In the meantime, I have a very good relationship with him. Different kind of a guy, but he probably thinks the same thing about me. We have a different kind of a relationship. We have a very good relationship, and there's no war. And, you know, about 2 months ago, he broke into a certain area. They said, oh, there's going to be trouble. I said, no, they're not, because he's not going to do that. And I was right. Look, instead of being in a war where millions of people, Seoul, you know, is 25 miles away, millions and millions, 32 million people in Seoul. Millions of people would be dead right now.
President Trump, that's 30 seconds.
We don't have a war, and I have a good relationship.
Vice President Biden, to you, North Korea conducted 4 nuclear tests under the Obama administration. Why do you think you would be able to rein in this persistent threat?
Because I'd make it clear, which we were making clear to China, they had to be part of the deal. Because here's the root. I made it clear, and as a spokesperson of the administration when I went to China, that they said, why are you moving your missile defense up so close? Why are you moving more forces here? Why are you continuing to do military maneuvers with South Korea? I said, because North Korea is a problem, and we're going to continue to do it so we can control them. We're going to make sure we can control them and make sure they cannot hurt us. And so if you want to do something about it, step up and help. If not, it's going to continue. What has he done? He's legitimized North Korea. He's talked about his good buddy, who's a thug, and he talks about how we're better off, and they have much more capable missiles, able to reach U.S. territory much more easily than ever did before.
Let me follow up with you, Vice President Biden. You've said you wouldn't meet with Kim Jong-un without preconditions. Are there any conditions under which you would meet with him?
On the condition that he would agree that he would be drawing down his nuclear capacity to get that the Korean Peninsula should be nuclear-free zone.
All right, let's move on to American families.
Kristen, they tried
Very
to
quickly,
meet with
10
him.
Seconds, President.
They tried to meet with him. He I wouldn't didn't. Do it. He didn't like Obama. He didn't like him. He wouldn't do it.
Okay,
I got
to give
fact,
him a chance to respond to that before we move
on. He wouldn't do it. And
no
that's
way.
Okay. You know what? North Korea, we're not in a war. We have a good relationship. You know, people don't understand. Having a good relationship
Trump,
with leaders of
on,
other countries is
a lot
good
of country,
thing.
We have a lot of questions to get
yes,
to.
Not
your response.
Like saying we had a good relationship with Hitler before he, in fact, invaded Europe. The rest of Europe. Come on. The reason he would not meet with President Obama is because President Obama said, we're going to talk about denuclearization. We're not going to legitimize you. We're going to continue to put stronger and stronger sanctions on you. That's why he wouldn't meet with us.
All right.
And
let's
it didn't
move
happen.
On. Let's
Excuse
move
me.
On and talk about
he
American
left me
families.
A mess, Kristen.
President Trump. Okay, we
they
do need to move on.
They left me a mess. North Korea was a mess.
We
and in fact, if you
so
remember the first two or three months,
tonight,
there was a very
Trump.
Dangerous period in my first 3 months before we sort of worked things out a little bit.
Okay.
There was a very they left us a mess. And Obama would be, I think, the first to say it was the single biggest problem he thought that our country.
Okay.